Now for initializing our RTC 2311 register, we have two registers, control and the control and status register. These two registers are very crucial and plays very important role. Now what exactly these two registers do? First, moving to the control register, out of the 8 bits, the important bits which are the bit 5 and the bit 4, 3, 2 and the 1, 0. Bit 5 is the bit which actually starts converting the temperature conversion. So when we set the bit 5, we start the conversion of the temperature, and we can get the temperature data from the last two registers, which from the 11H and 12H. Okay, and now comes the bit 4, 3, 2. Now bit 4, 3, 2 controls the operation of the int slash SWQ pin. This pin outputs the square wave of frequency 1 hertz, 1 kilohertz, 4 kilohertz, or 8 kilohertz, depending upon the bit 4 and 3, which configures that what exactly frequency we will be wanting for the output square wave from the int slash SQW pin, and bit 2 control its operation. Now bit 2, which is the INTCN bit, controls the operation of the int of the SWQ pin. Now, as you can see in the figure in the right-hand side, that if INTCN is set to logic 0, then we will get a continuous square wave output on the SWQ and the SQW pin, and depending upon the frequency which we have set from the bit 4 and bit 3. But when we set this INCTN bit to logic 1, then we will get this square wave output only when our alarm register and the timekeeping register matches. That is, when the alarm time which we want, that time occurs, then we get the square wave output of the required for the defined frequency. And now the bit 1 and the bit 0 controls the output signal on matching the alarm and the timekeeping register. That means when we set INCTN to the logic 1, and when we set the alarm 2 interrupt enable or the alarm 1 interrupt enable to the logic 1, we will get then the INT and the SWQ pin will be asserted for the output. So for initializing, what main bits which we need to set are the bit 5 for converting our temperature. And if we need to use the alarm feature of this, then we need to set INCTN to the logic 1, A2IE and the A1IE to the logic 1 for getting the output on the alarm register and the timekeeping register matches. And by default, RS2 and RS1 are set as default values as shown in the data sheet. So for initializing our control register, we set the value of, that is, we first set the bit 5 to the set 1 logic high. And for like you can configure RS2 and RS1 to the any required frequency which you need. And if you need to enable the alarm thing, then you need to set the bit 2, bit 1, bit 0 to the 1. But for this, for the our code, I have not used the alarm function and I have set this to the 0, so it will not output on the alarm in the time register on matching. It will continuously output the square wave of the frequency 0, 1, that is of 1 kilohertz on the INT slash SQW pin. Now comes to the status register. As its name says, status register, it tells the status on when we are having the I2C communication. So out of this function, out of these bits, the one of the most important is the bit 3, enable 32 kilohertz output. So the pin, another pin which we have with our is a 32K pin. It will output the 32 kilohertz square wave on this pin on enabling this bit to the 1. And the another bit which is important are these A2F and the A1F. So the A2F and the A1F are used for monitoring whether an alarm has occurred or not, because A2F will be set to logic 1 only when our timekeeping register and the alarm register has been set, has matched, and it will generate, and on setting the A2F to the 1, it will generate the output wave depend when we have set the INT and the this interrupt enable of the corresponding alarm. So that's it for the register description that we are important ones. And for the time temperature register, there is normal that the MSB 11-1H. That is 11H is the first you will write the address at the temp for the temperature register 11H. Then we will start reading the data from the previous location, that is the 11. So MSB will be read and then LSB will be read, and then there is a formula for converting our this temperature into the human understandable decimal format of temperature, and we simply return the temperature value. So that's the important thing that we need to understand from the register descriptions and the registers. I hope you get a clear idea that how exactly are we get the data from the IRTC 3231 and what are its register descriptions and how exactly the register behaves. Now in the next video, I am going to show you the code part. I am going to show you how do we read, write. Like I will just explain you about this whole embedded C code for writing its application code using the I2C device driver. Now guys, I hope you are liking the content and the quality of the videos which I have been uploading on this channel, with basically concentrating mainly on how to make you understand about firmware development, on how to read the data sheet and interface a sensor or a module to a microcontroller with understanding its data sheet and the registers. So to all the viewers who are coming for the first time and viewing these videos of this channel, so do subscribe to the channel, and as a reward to me for my efforts and the knowledge which you can see from the content from the videos of my channel. So kindly subscribe the channel and press the notification bell to get notified for the new videos which will be uploaded on the firmware development. And mention down your any queries or your doubts or your reviews in the comment section. And that's it now, guys.